Welcome to HelpDesk TV. My name is Rudy Stebby. File history is a new file backup and restore feature of Windows 8. It works just like the Windows Restore Point, allowing you to save the user profile folders to any external storage device so they can be easily restored at any time. Unlike many third-party file backup utilities, it keeps track of file versions to easily identify and restore the file version you want to its original location. The file history can be accessed from the Control Panel. To begin, go to the Start screen, type Control Panel, and hit Enter. It will open the Control Panel. Now click on the System and Security option. Upon click, it will show all the system and security related tools. Just scroll down the page and click File History. Windows 8 recommends users to specify any external location for creating the file backup. So before you can begin, plug in an external drive or click Change Drive to specify any remote network location. Once an external drive path or network drive is selected, it will allow you to set up file history settings. The file history feature is designed to create regular backups of all folders in libraries, including music, documents, videos, and pictures, as well as your desktop, contacts, and favorites. By default, it saves copies of files after every hour and sets the file deletion option to never delete the backed up versions. However, you can choose to change the backup time interval, keep backed up files for only a specified amount of time, and select the size of the offline cache, whether it be 2%, 5%, 10%, or 20% of the disk space. If you set up a home group network group to access and share files between home PCs, enable Recommend This Drive option under the Home Group section. Moreover, you can view the file history event logs to view any errors during a backup operation. The file history feature automatically detects the plugged-in external storage device. You can also choose any remote location from the Change Drive window, accessible from the left sidebar. Here, you can add a network location where you want to back up your files. File history replicates the folder hierarchy of files which you choose to back up at the target location. This helps you quickly find files from the backup locations by only identifying their location in the source path. The file history will immediately start moving your data to the new target location specified from the Change Drive window. For instance, if you change the target location from an external USB storage device to a network drive, it will ask you to start moving your data to the new specified network location. This may prevent you from manually moving data between the old and new backup locations. The Restore Personal options found in the navigation bar to the left lets you view and choose files which are to be restored to their original locations. After connecting the backup drive, click Restore Personal Files and select the libraries and folders you want to restore. Once done, click the Restore button present between the navigation buttons to start moving or replacing the files with the selected version of files. The File History Restore feature shows the timestamp of the backup folder and files. It's advised to verify the file version before you start the file restore process. The Settings icon menu includes a complimentary option to restore a selected backed up folder to any other local or remote location. Click the settings icon to select the Restore To option. It brings up a file browser for you to choose the target location. All you need is to specify the target location to start restoring files to that location. The file history feature also comes integrated with the Windows 8 Ribbon Explorer. If the backup drive is connected, you can easily view and restore previously saved versions of files from the history option in the Open section of the Windows Explorer ribbon. After the first run of a file history backup operation, you should check the destination path to verify whether all the required folders and libraries have been backed up or not. I hope you enjoyed today's Help Desk TV. Please join us on our help forums at forums.helpdesktv.ca. There you can further discuss today's topic or just to ask another question you need help with. See you there.